Time has expired. I thank the member for Bruce. The question is that the motion be agreed to, and I give the call to the member for Ryan.
Thank you, Mr. Deputy Speaker. I rise to support this motion and in so doing congratulate the member for Brisbane for bringing this issue onto the formal agenda of our parliament. Freedom to learn is a fundamental right that must be afforded to all. In Australia, we often take for granted the ease with which our children access education. Education is seen as a fact of life, available to all, no fuss, no questions. Across the world, however, this is not always the case. Access to school and to an education for many women, even in an economically booming country such as Nigeria, has seen women face many challenges in order to obtain equal education to men. A positive correlation exists between the enrolment of girls in primary school and the gross national product and increase of life expectancy. It is due to this correlation that enrolment in schools represents the largest component of the investment in human capital in any society. Rapid socioeconomic development of a nation has been observed to depend on the calibre of women and their education in that country. Education bestows on women a disposition for a lifelong acquisition of knowledge, values, attitudes, competence and skills. The heinous abduction of these 200 schoolgirls by the Islamist militant group Boko Haram, whose name means, as we've heard, Western education is a sin, has again highlighted the danger that many young girls face when attempting to go to school, and that sections of some countries still wish to stand in the way of the right to equal education for women and continue to suppress them in society. In Nigeria, there are large disparities between the education for boys and the education for girls. Many girls do not have access to adequate education past a certain age. Currently, the female adult literacy rate, which is ages 15 and above, for the country of 59.4%, in comparison to the male adult literacy rate of 74.4%. It is differences in education that have led to this gap in literacy. There are various cultural and socioeconomic issues that prevent women from having adequate access to education. One prominent cultural view is that it is better for the women to stay home and learn to tend to their family instead of attending school. Nigerian tradition attaches higher value to a man than a woman whose place is believed to be in the kitchen. A study by the University of Ibadan linked the imbalance in boys' and girls' participation to the long-held belief in male superiority and female subordination. This situation has been further aggravated by patriarchal practices which gave girls no traditional rights to succession. Therefore, the same patriarchal practices encourage preference to be given to the education of a boy rather than a girl. The decline in economic activity since the early 1980s has made education a luxury to many Nigerians, especially to those in rural areas. Because Nigerian parents are known to invest in children depending on their sex, birth order or natural endowment, girls and boys are not treated equally. Often the family can only afford to send one child to school. Because daughters have assumed responsibilities in the home, they are less likely to be the one to attend school. With so many factors already challenging these Nigerian schoolgirls and holding them back from obtaining an education, this latest abduction is a tragic atrocity. As the Foreign Minister Julie Bishop has stated, the Australian community, along with the global community, is rightly outraged. We completely condemn the group responsible for these attacks. The Australian government is moving urgently to list Boko Haram under the Criminal Code as a terrorist organisation, and terrorist offences carry penalties of up to 25 years of imprisonment in Australia. The Foreign Minister has offered Australia's support to the Nigerian government through our Ambassador for Counterterrorism. There is a strong international pressure for Nigeria to accept the offers of assistance, particularly from the United States, the United Kingdom and others. Nigeria has welcomed our support for their counterterrorism efforts. The situation is quite perilous, as is understood that the girls have been separated into groups. There is a great deal of concern about the separation of the girls, because if you try to free one group, it could have an adverse impact on the other group. And the Foreign Minister has advised that the security concerns are being considered very carefully. I recently joined the hashtag #BringBackOurGirls social media campaign with fellow parliamentary friends of Amnesty co-convener the member for Scullin in support of Michelle Obama's condemnation of this atrocity and a call to action for other countries to stand up for these schoolgirls and see their safe release.
I thank the member for Ryan.
Well done.
The question is